Here on the Great Plains, our plant life can't expect a whole lot of annual rainfall, and they'll be subjected to extreme temperatures, both low lows and high highs. But some hardy plants have found a way to thrive here, and that is something that the Great Plains Native Plant Society wants to celebrate. They have created the Great Plains Botanic Garden to showcase this flora. And that garden is located 5 miles south of Hermosa. They're holding an open house this Friday and Saturday. We're going to learn more from Cindy Reed, president of the Great Plains Native Plant Society. She's with us from SDPB's Black Hills Surgical Hospital Studio in Rapid City. Cindy, welcome to In the Moment. Thanks for being here.
Thank you for the invitation.
I have been to this wonderful place in its earliest ideas. Tell us a little bit, for people who have not been out to Hermosa and have not walked around, what you might expect to see.
If you come Friday and Saturday to our open house, you will see lots of blooming flowers. I just did a walk around this morning, and there's about maybe a couple dozen native wildflowers that nobody planted. Some of them were not here, you know, when Lewis and Clark saw the Great Plains. That's our goal, is to learn more about the native plants of the Great Plains, which is, what, of course, what they saw.
What's the inspiration? Who is the inspiration for this garden?
Well, this was a brainchild of mine that I had because I lived next door, as we say in West River, you know, if you live 5 or 10 miles away from right. your neighbors, you're living next door. And I lived next to Claude Barr, a rancher who actually passed away in the early 1980s. But he, in his lifetime, had become internationally known as the person to go to and visit if you wanted to learn more about the native plants of the Great Plains, particularly the wildflowers. He called his ranch the Prairie Gem Ranch. He raised cows and wrote poetry, too, but he really also loved the wildflowers. And he actually had a business selling the wildflowers. So people learned of him, and academics, people from museums and botanic gardens and various professors from around the world, really. The biggest botanic gardens in the world are in London, and those people came out to see him to learn more, and there were plants that the academic world considered extinct, and lo and behold, he's gardening away, saying, nope, there it is. I know where to find it out in the wild.
Yeah,
that was a penstemon from the sandhills.
Yeah, if you open a little drawer in some botanical research facility on the East Coast or in London, you'll find something from our neighborhood. Describe
yes.
some of the flowers that you find interesting and delightful to watch and important scientifically, but also in your life.
Well, you know, the penstemons, Mr. Barr was very fond of penstemons. There's a fascinating group of people that are fond of penstemons, and that called the American Penstemon Society. And one of the reasons penstemons are so fun is because they are North American only. Most genuses are found around the world, but penstemons are found only here in North America. South Dakota has about 6 species, and Claude Barr raised a lot more than that. He said that since we live right here in the center part of the Great Plains, in every meaning of the word, that would be altitude, longitude, and latitude, so he thought that we could grow a really wide variety of species of the native plants of the Great Plains. And we have, in his memory, we have commenced a penstemon display, and we intend to attempt to grow as many as we possibly can to show what penstemons might you grow here. Penstemons are a tubular flower that looks like people call them bluebells often.
All right. I'm going to spell penstemon for radio listeners. P-E-N-S-T-E-M-O-N. So you can look up
right.
what that looks
right.
like. Can you? Okay, so we'll go back to the open house here. If people want to grow native plants, what sort of information, knowledge, or even, you know, seeds would they be able to get at this open house that would help them on their journey?
We don't have seeds to offer yet, I'm sorry to say, but you will be able to see about, I think that at the moment there's about six species of penstemons in bloom this morning, and there's three or four more in just instant pop bud. We'll see what happens by Saturday or Friday. You will also be able to see a good collection of the cacti that live in South Dakota. Many people are astonished to learn that cactus grow in South Dakota, which, of course, as a ranch girl from out in the western part of South Dakota, I'm well aware that cactus are native here. And we have, again, about six species of cactus, and some of them are in bloom right now.
All right. So the annual open house at the Great Plains Botanical Garden is Friday and Saturday from 9 to 4 local time. You're going to head off South Dakota Highway 79, go about 5 miles south of Hermosa. If you want to get more specific, go to the Great Plains Native Plant Society website, and we'll put a link up on our website as well so you can find everything. And if it's a nice day, even if it's not a nice day, you're just going to feel like you live in the best place in the world when you go out there.
If you go 5 miles south of Hermosa on 79 and look to the left or the east, you will see a little log cabin.
Yeah.
Might remind you kind of Laura Ingalls Wilder look. That is our headquarters.
I love it. All right, Cindy.
It's not far off the road.
Thank you so much. I appreciate your time.